Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I will show you how to work with pattern swatches. I love saving my patterns as swatches, but I know that many people are not familiar with them, and that's why I want to show you how to save patterns as swatches, how to save and open pattern collections, and how to apply them to your artwork. Let's take a look at the swatches panel. If you can see it, just go to Window Swatches to open it. As you can see, Illustrator comes with predefined colors, but if you want to remove them, just click on the first color swatch, then click on the last color swatch, and drag them all to the trash can icon. Illustrator comes with many swatch libraries. Just go to the swatch libraries menu in the lower left corner of the swatches panel and select one of the swatches. If you are looking for patterns, just go to patterns and select one of the pattern libraries. I am going to select Monster Patterns. You can use the patterns directly from this menu, or you can add them to the swatches panel. If you want to add them to the swatches panel, just click on the pattern swatch you want to add. If you want to add more than one, you can select all of them, go to the menu and click Add to Swatches. As you can see, all of the swatches are now in the swatches panel. I'm going to close this tab and show you how to save patterns. You can download these patterns from my website. The download link is in the video description. Just click on the download button, unzip the file, and double click on one of the Illustrator files to open them. You will find six pattern tiles, and you will also find six pattern swatches in the swatches panel. These six patterns are all seamless pattern tiles made with the same method I showed you in a previous video. If you want to save your seamless pattern tiles, just select the one you want to save and drag it to the swatches panel. As you can see, it now appears here. If you want to rename it, just select it in the swatches panel and then go to the menu and swatch options. Just give it a new name and click OK. You can also save the patterns to the swatches panel by using the pattern tool. So I'm going to select this pattern and then go to Object, Pattern, Make. This will open up the pattern maker and you can see a preview of your pattern. So you can give it a new name and click Done. When your pattern collection is done, just go to the Swatches Libraries menu to save them. Go to Save Swatches, and Illustrator will automatically open the Swatches folder. If you save your patterns here, you will have easy access to them, but you can also save them in another folder on your computer. I'm going to save them in the Swatches folder. So let's find these pattern swatches and apply them to our artwork. I'm going to go back to the Swatches Libraries menu, and under User Defined, you can find the three patterns I've saved. Just click on them, and as you can see, the new menu will open. If you've saved a pattern in another folder, you will have to go to Other Library and search for the patterns on your computer. These are the same patterns, but they are saved in two different folders. Pattern swatches work just like color swatches. So if you want to add them to a shape, just select the pattern you want to use and then let's draw a star. As you can see, our pattern is applied to the star. And if you want to change the pattern, just select another pattern from the swatches menu. You can also use the swatches with the brush tool. I'm going to use the blob brush tool, and you can just draw a shape. This is a very ugly flower, but you can see it has the pattern applied to it. And again, you can use other patterns on this shape. You can also use it with the type tool. So select your pattern and then select the type tool. I am going to use a different font, a bold font, and let's make it larger. Just like before, you can change the pattern. Let's also apply the patterns to an illustration. I have here a potted plant and I want to change the pattern on the flower pot. So just select the shape you want to add the pattern to and add the pattern. And you can also add it on leaves, and you can even add a pattern as a stroke. So I'm going to select the stroke and let's add this yellow. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!